Breaking news, South Florence High School. We have school today. Get to school.
Thank you. Amelia Sprawls, and I am a high school student living in this 2020 coronavirus epidemic. We have been out of school for a while now, and I'll be honest, the first couple of days into our online school transition, I sort of felt lost, as if I had nothing to do except schoolwork and watch YouTube, just as pretty much any teenager would do. Towards the end of the first week, my mom began to talk about making mask covers for our local nurses and health workers. My brother and I, who are at less risk than my mom, headed out before the outbreak got any worse, and then we gathered some supplies to make these mask covers the community was talking about. By this point of our online schooling, I have learned the pros and cons, routines, and reasons for a lot of this. My family has gathered a few things for our grandma so she will have everything that she needs while social distancing and possible quarantining. I have also called to check on her several times since she is elderly and at a higher risk of becoming ill due to the coronavirus. If you didn't know, many neighborhoods have been placing stuffed animal bears in windows as sort of a little scavenger hunt for little kids, but really any family to participate in. Since social distancing has become more and more serious, the community has been trying to come up with ideas to lift the spirits of everyone and also have a little bit of fun while staying safe and healthy. Our family decided to take this to a whole new level and make a zoo of our house. We have placed different stuffed animals in every window, even multiple animals in each window. Throughout the past week, we have seen so many golf carts and cars stop in front of our house with kids' bright, smiling little faces in the window, spotting all the different animals. Some cars even went to the end of the road and turned back around just to come back and take a second look. My favorite thing I have been doing throughout this online schooling process has been bike riding almost every day with my family. Some days I ride with my siblings and dad, some days it is just my siblings and I, but every time I cherish it because I know we may never have this time again. During the rides, I also enjoy the beautiful scenery we are blessed to have around us. Someone told me during the COVID-19 outbreak that it is hard to believe that even with all this fear, panic, and rushing lifestyle, all you have to do is step outside, and it's like you're not even in the same world. It is amazing and breathtaking, especially with those sunny 80-degree days. Another thing I would like to point out is how blessed a lot of us are. We need to realize that there are some people who don't even have the opportunity to stock up on supplies and food. So when you head out to gather stuff, try not to take every product in the store, and especially if you truly have plenty of what you're looking for, leave the rest for someone who may have to wait for a paycheck to buy them later. Something else I feel our generation needs to realize and consider is the connectivity between the big companies of the United States that has happened. If you just turn on your TV, you will see all these companies coming together to provide any and all supplies and funds to help health workers, other businesses, and the people of America in general. It's incredible. Students, especially in middle and high school, who tend to not care about the government or an economy, need to turn on their TV once in a while during this time and see how these people have turned from working for themselves to helping so many other people. In my opinion, it is incredible how one minute there is so much diversity and hatred in America and other countries, and then the next second, in times of crisis like this, panic and fear, people turn to each other and begin to provide for others. I just think that this is something to think about. If you have any free time, I would take a minute to look up how the amazing people of these places like Italy, they play music together as an act of kindness and love. These people are in much worse shape than us, and they're so much less fortunate, yet they bring out the happiness and positive aspects of this scary time. I just wanted to scratch the surface of the light side of humans and their incredible ways. So if you are just sitting around right now, not knowing what to do, thinking, why is this happening? Just remember, there is a reason for this. You may have another reason than someone else, but there is something that you could make better, something you could strengthen, someone you could help. There is something. Maybe you could make mask covers for your local health workers, showing you are there for them and you support them. Maybe you need to begin to check on your grandparents or older family members more. Show them they're not alone. Maybe you can do something to bring joy to your community and try to drive out the fear and panic. Just like Martin Luther King Jr. once said, Life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? Maybe you now have the opportunity to strengthen relationships with your family or the Lord or whatever it is that you are struggling with. Just don't sit around and think, I hate school, now I have nothing to do. Or, this is scary, what do I do? Do something for others while you have the time, because you do not know when you may not have that chance anymore. Take the time to see what others in this world are doing to help others, and maybe you will be inspired somehow. Try and seek the positive out of every situation. And lastly, just remember, there is always a reason.